guys, it's Alma's here. Today I'm bringing you a traditional dish that my family make around Easter. It's la cuaresma o Lent. And capirotada is one of the main dishes we had to have a Good Friday. And usually the first day that you start making capirotada is Ash Wednesday. And out of those 40 days, you can make it every Friday. And on Good Friday, we usually make 12 dishes. Out of those 12 dishes, capirotada is one of the stuff. I'm gonna make it the way my mom and my grandma teach it, but I modified a little bit to make it a little bit easy. So vamos a empezar. You need 4 bolillos, half a cup of butter or oil, olive oil, whatever you choose. 8 ounces of piloncillo or brown sugar. 2 sticks of cinnamon. It has to be the stick, not powder. 3 ounces of sprinkles, or en español es grajea. It has to be the small sprinkles because it's 2 sizes. One is too big, the little ones. This is the ingredients you must have, but my family also add these additional ingredients, which is 2 ounces of raisins, 2 ounces of coconut, 1 ounce of pecan, queso fresco, any queso you have, banana, 1 ounce of peanuts. If you don't like any of these, you can just take it out. Lastly, you want to need 5 cups of water, pot, and a pan. I'm using one is 8x8. Alright guys, so I just put 5 cups of water in my pot, and I'm going to put cinnamon, 2 sticks of cinnamon, and 8 ounces of piloncillo or brown sugar. This is the thing that's gonna give you the flavor to my capirotada. I almost forgot to put my raisins in the water. If you do decide to use raisins, this is a good time to put it in the water, to boil the water. And we're gonna let it cook between 25 to 30 minutes. It should be ready. We're not gonna cover. We're gonna put it in medium heat. I'm gonna turn up the oven, 350. All right guys, in the meantime, we're cooking our cinnamon, and we have preheat the oven. We're gonna move on to cut our bread, and we're gonna cut it like probably like 1 inch thicker, and we're gonna do it like that for the 4 bread. If you want to use more bread, you could. If you want to use less, you could. Okay guys, it's a lot of different ways you can make capirotada. I choose today to use butter, but you can also choose to use olive oil or manteca, lard, whatever you choose. My family usually use lard, but I like butter. So I'm gonna use 1/2 cup, and I'm gonna heat it in the microwave to melt it a little bit to this step. And I'm just gonna put it in the microwave maybe for the 30 seconds, not very long. Alright guys, so I'm gonna just do it like that. My family usually fry it in the pan. You can also do that too, but I'm gonna just put it in the oven. It seems for me to be a more easy. So I'm just gonna put some butter in both sides. Okay, so I already put butter in my breads on both sides, and so now I'm gonna put it to baking for 25 minutes to 30 minutes. I'm gonna check it like around 25 minutes, and then we wanted to make it brown, completely brown, so we just put it there. We're coming and shaking in 20 minutes. One tip that I wanted to give you when you're going to the store, if you've been trying to make this ones, I had 2 packets. With 2 packets, made 3 ounces of 1/3 cup of sprinkles. But this, usually I wanted to show you, the sprinkles are really, really little. Because there's 2 kinds that I have seen in the store. One is kind of big. This is really, really tiny sprinkles. So trying to go for this one, not for the big one. You'll find all the sprinkles, the coconuts, and the pecans. Everything in the same pile. If you're gonna make it around this time, around Easter, you will find it. If you don't wanna plan an amount to make it in a different time that is not Easter, you also find it when it's all the season. Most of like Mexican store, they have it. All right guys, so I have a queso fresco over here. I have 10 ounces. You can use any cheese you like, and I'm just gonna cut in a little squares. You can use cheese if you like. If you don't, just take this ingredient up. So I'm just gonna cut little squares, thinner. Okay, so my cinnamon and my brown on my piloncillo has been cooking for 30 minutes. To this point, we're just gonna turn it up, and we're just gonna wait for our bread. And I am going to use 1 banana. I'm just gonna cut it really thin so we can spread it over the bread. All right, guys, so my bread is baking for 25 minutes, so I'm gonna just take it out. And as you can see, it's really brown, so that's what we want. I forgot to mention also that you can buy it in the store, they're already prepared, but I like to make my own, which is not really difficult, but you just put it in the oven and then it takes better. So that's one. I got the other one too. And now we can just work it and put our capirotada together. Be careful because all these things is really high. You can let it go down. We'll use it like that. So I'm have my cinnamon and piloncillo over here. Just gonna put it right here. And I'm going to use one of these to put my bread. We're gonna make layers. So I usually grab one and stick it inside, both sides. It's gonna make noise. When the bread is really soaked, so I'm just gonna put it here. And we're gonna do the same thing with every single one. And we go to the next one. And we're gonna make layers. So I have my first layer. So what I'm gonna do with my layers, I'm gonna put some cheese first. One in this one. And I'm gonna add bananas. And I have pecans. So now I am going to add a little bit of peanuts. And also I have my raisins here because I boil it with the cinnamon. So just gonna put a couple. So after that I have all these ingredients, I'm gonna go with the cocoa. Just gonna spread some of it. And the thing that makes give you the color, the light, is the sprinkles. I love these things. Every time I see this one, it looks so beautiful. And I cannot tell you guys the house smells amazing just with the cinnamon, because the cinnamon gives it really like good flavor. That's one layer. We're gonna go to the second layer. We're gonna go the same process. I'm gonna keep the bread. All right, guys, so also when you guys put the bread in the water, use your intuition. So do not let it too long in the water or too little. You'll feel it when it starts getting soggy. You take it out, because if you leave it too long, it's gonna just fall apart. All right, guys, so this is my second layer, and this is how much water I have left over, which is fine. Oh, it's always better to have a little more than less. Put my queso, the bananas, the peanuts, cocoa, and grajea. This is my favorite part. I just love the rainbow. When I was growing up, it was a guy that used to come and sell some shoes, and he used to come in a motorcycle, and he has a lot of freckles in her face, and we used to call him La Capirotada. And the reason we used to call him La Capirotada is because he has a lot of spots, and every time we hear him, we say, oh, ahí viene La Capirotada. All right, guys, so now that I put all my ingredients together, the last thing to do is just to put it in the oven for 25 minutes, and that'll be it. 350. My capirotada has been cooking for 25 minutes, so now it's turn up the oven. And it's done. We're just gonna let it cool down for 10 minutes, and it's ready to eat. All right, guys, so there you have my capirotada. But this is one of the original way that I used to, my grandma and my mother used to gather together and make it. And I hopefully you try. We'll see. Hopefully you learn something new. So hasta la vista.